Yes, we're loading the dip, and as we do it, I'm looking for lower prices on gems. Today's video is going to be about coins that I want to buy more of as this dip continues. If it does continue, of course. So understand the conditions for this video are that we dip further in a little bit of a last shakeout before we finish or start moving towards the end of this accumulation phase, which ends at 48,000. Once we break above that again, I think we're full send mode. So go ahead, destroy that like button. Non-likers shall never enter the Citadel. And of course, we're going to be walking you through some of these gems that have done many X's this month. And again, those who are subscribed with the bell notification on will always be ahead of those who are not. So make sure you're subscribed with that bell notification on. With that said, let's dive into this gems list. Now, as always, I want to make a couple things clear before I talk about any of these altcoins. One, I hold these altcoins and I am rooting for them. I am biased. I want them to win. So you can consider this information from someone who is holding the bags, right? That's number one. Number two, I want you to know that these are super, super risky. If you guys are new to crypto and you don't know how altcoins work, they can go up 100x and they can also go down negative 90% when the market crashes. So you need to be prepared for that volatility, and you shouldn't invest, in my opinion, not financial advice, but you should not invest money that you can't afford to lose in this market. This is where a little bit goes a long way, and you really need to understand the risks of playing in the deep end of the pool, which is precisely where I love to play, because that's where the highest risks are, but that's also where the highest rewards are. With that said, we're going to dive in to what I think are the things to be looking at over the next few weeks as this market goes on a potential mega dip fire sale as the FUD continues to pile on. First and foremost, we have my baby AVAX. That's right. We've been talking about this over the last few weeks, and money, attention, and excitement are just pouring into the Avalanche ecosystem. So if this thing goes back on sale again, I will scoop up some more. Again, I'm pretty cozy in my bags. I did go crazy hard on Avalanche already, but if we go back down to that sort of $50 range or below, I'm getting hungry and I'm eating up because I believe it's going to run it back turbo. We also have the number one leading DEX here on Avalanche, in my opinion, which is Joe, Trader Joe XYZ. Here, and that's because Joe has been on an absolute tear. We brought it to you right as it hit this dip here and came down to about $1.60 here, somewhere in that range, and it went and it hit even almost $4.60 or something like that. So almost a full 3x here out of Trader Joe. And if this thing dumps on a dip, which I'm not so sure it will, but if it does dump significantly, especially down to this $2 range, I'm loading up crazy because this is going to run it back turbo. And then once we make new Bitcoin all-time highs, I think coins like Joe do at least a 5x, probably a 10x. So if we come back down and dump pretty aggressively, this to me is an easy 30 to 50x out of the rest of the year. So I'm going to be going pretty hard on this. Again, these are wild estimates. You guys got to make your own decisions here, but I do believe Trader Joe is, in my opinion, one of the best bets in the market if we dump. Now we also have Solana. Now, as we know, Solana here has been pumping aggressively without any real pause for several months. And now we've had a nice period of sort of like, this really looks like a nice trend reversal here. So if this thing dumps down really hard, maybe down to like the sub $100 range, I don't know if that's possible. Maybe that's FUD. But if this dumps down sort of down to this range, 70 bucks, I'll probably be loading up a lot because I think Solana is going to run it back turbo again. Solana just has a ton of developer activity. It did get hurt significantly by that reboot of the blockchain. It really called into question a lot of people's faith in the project. But I can tell you with confidence, I'm talking to so many projects, there's a lot of builders, a lot of attention, a lot of money being poured into the Solana ecosystem. And it, in my opinion, is positioned well for the next few weeks and months. It's one to watch for sure. So have Solana on your list here. If you're looking for fire sales on coins that you might've missed out on, this one, if it gets back to the sub $100 range, I think is a juicy buy. Speaking of Solana gems, we also have Star Atlas here. I told you guys Star Atlas was way overvalued at the beginning. And this was as it was peaking up. Everyone was FOMOing into it. And it was up here at like, you know, something like a $10 billion fully diluted valuation. That's just ridiculous and unsustainable for a project that's barely functional. So of course, having it come down here, it's still pretty expensive to me, about a $3 billion TVL. I'd like to see this project come down to under a $1 billion TVL. And that's where I'd start to get hungry. And you could say a $1 billion TVL is also still ridiculous. But again, this is a crypto bull market. And it is in some ways an industry leader in the gaming sector. At least there's a lot of ambition and hope and Sam backing here. So this is one of those projects that if it starts to get pretty cheap here, and I'm thinking like maybe 3 cents or below, that's where I'd start to get kind of hungry and want to start gobbling up the dip. Everything they put out looks good and all, but still 3 cents, I'm starting to get hungry. And that's where I'd start to look to really get an advantageous entry into this. Another gaming project that I am obviously holding, I got in about the 0.01, I got in about one here. And I'm hoping if this thing comes down, UFO Gaming, I'm talking with the team a lot. I actually got Alex into this project as well. Alex Becker, I made him aware of it. And we've both been chatting with the team. What they're showing us looks pretty good, you know? And so as we're seeing, the price seems to be pretty resilient here around this $200 mark here. And so we'll see how this goes. Again, I think that this thing, if it gets a nice dip again, would be a nice thing to reload on. And it'll probably run its way back up because they do have some pretty good looking stuff coming for the gaming side of things. And they're just really an aggressive team building fast and in the right space. They're good at marketing too. They have decent volume on their coin, even on a day like today, about $3 million. So I think that this is a coin that could do really well in running it back. Again, this is looking for a dip and I could see it being pretty resilient here. As you can see, other things are not having quite the resilience, but it looks like it's wanting to maybe hit a bottoming sort of reaccumulation formation here around the 200s. We'll see. Even if it goes down, this is one that I could see having a nice dip on. And just to be clear, my entry price was about 100 here. 100 as it pertains to 0.00000100. You guys get it. Finally, Sushi. As you guys know, I'm a Sushi Ultra Bull. I'm a big fan of this project. They have their NFT OpenSea Killer coming. I think it's a very, very good project that you need to have your eyes on. Of course, most people know about Sushi, but you can actually get a piece of the protocol rewards here by staking for X Sushi. And as you can see, it's just gotten beat up here. Can't help but feel that there's a little bit of whale manipulation keeping prices a little bit suppressed here on Sushi. So if this thing gets beaten down to like the $6 range or even below, that's where I'm going to be looking for a pretty juicy entry into SushiSwap. So this is one that I think is probably a pretty on the safer bet, most likely to run it back. Again, D-Race, this one has done really, really well. Alex was tweeting about it here when it got exploited, and that's when I really jumped in here to D-Race. So I got this $1.50 or so price tag on it, and it's done phenomenally well since. We'll see if this thing dips at all. Again, it's a gaming crypto coin, should do pretty well at running it back. We saw it bounce back from a pretty aggressive dip before. So if it ends up getting crushed and sort of breaking the support here around $3, coming down to those low $2 ranges, might be a good one to keep your eyes on. And finally, Osmosis. Osmosis is just a really solid project. You can see this great growth here, but again, it's starting to kind of get away from people. So if this thing gets crushed, if we do get a capitulation here down to the low 30s, this is one that I think is a super, super good bet, as it's a very important blue chip project there on Cosmos. So remember I was telling you, Cosmos, Polkadot, Avalanche, those ecosystems are ones that are full of opportunity to absolutely crush it, especially for newer, smaller wallets that maybe are looking for bigger sized gains, as opposed to bigger wallets that are looking for more wealth growth and preservation. I find that a lot of people get into altcoins because they want sort of extraordinary gains, and so they have a higher risk appetite. Now, another piece of warning here, absolutely all of these coins could dump down to Goblin Town. If you're not careful here, they could easily lose 90% of their value. So make sure you're aware that as you're making these decisions, you could easily lose a ton of money if you don't manage your risk properly here. You should not be going in on any of these altcoins in a way that is uncomfortable. And finally, we have the earliest of early movers here in Kusamaville, that is Moon River. And if Moon River gets crushed down to maybe the 200s or below here, as you can see, it's been just a gorgeous chart, but you saw a nice breakout here around the 180 range. If we come back down to test those prior highs, I would be excited to go scoop up some Moon River at what I consider to be good prices. As you can see, it's been in this sort of falling wedge formation now for the last few weeks. This is one that definitely has a bright future ahead of it. I don't actually hold a big enough bag of Moon River yet, so I'm actually kind of rooting on this thing to dump so that I can get some more coins. Again, if we get a capitulation, it'll probably break through this formation down and retest these highs, and that'll be a nice entry point for me where I believe it's easily going to regain its all-time high and beyond. So this is a big, I think a high percentage bet here, a strong project here on Kusama. And finally, for a total low cap, super low cap, super high risk risk DeFi play. We have RGT, RARI governance token. This one, I first came and brought it to the channel at about $4. It's done some interesting work. They just had an announcement the other day that actually doubled their TVL to about 400 million. Their market cap's about 200 million. I could see this thing on a nice dump down if it does end up breaking down and sort of revisiting this $10 or lower price point. I guess that being a phenomenal entry point, as I think in a bull run, sort of Q4 mode, this thing hitting $100 at the end of the year is certainly within the realm of possibility. This is a DeFi project. Remember, there is a lot of sort of regulatory scrutiny going on with DeFi projects. So just know that. And as always, understand a project like RARI could just as easily go back to the $4 range as much as it could go to the $100 range. So understand high risk, high reward play here. And yes, I do hold RARI governance token. And finally, I wanted to get into some NFT stuff, because what you'll see here is that the gains in NFTs are just clowning the gains in other projects. And yes, there's a ton of NFTs that suck. There's a ton of NFTs that only go down, but you could say the exact same thing about altcoins. There's a ton of bad altcoins out there. So when I first got you into Subducks and was talking about it all throughout this 0.2, 0.3 area, 0.1 even on average sale, the floor price was, you know, coming down. You could get Subducks as cheap as 0.1 here. Well, guess what? Now the average price of a Subduck as of today is literally 4.4 Ethereum. And yesterday you could see these volume spikes of huge, so many millions of dollars of Subducks being sold. And as we see now, even the floor, the cheapest Subduck in the world is 4.5 Ethereum. So if you swept up some Subducks at 0.1 ETH, you'd now be up 45X. Show me another coin that's up 45X in the last couple of months. Very hard to do. And a coin that was easily trading widely on the market that's now up 45X. That's like Solana style gains. So this is why I've been telling you guys to be paying attention to the good NFT projects. And not to mention, now my Subducks are giving me passive yield rewards. I'm a Subduck whale, as they would say, and I have a ton of these ducks. I gave away 4 of them, which now has a lowest level price here of about 18 ETH is what I gave away that day when I gave away 4 Subducks. So whoever has those Subducks, congratulations to you guys. And I'm not going to stop finding these early projects and trying to give them to you, because I've told you guys this over and over again, that the biggest, most asymmetric rewards will come from NFTs. And there's no better proof of that than Subducks, which I brought you literally on day one and I helped you understand. But a lot of people probably didn't listen. That's okay. You probably didn't understand it. But I'm here trying to decode this for you. A 45X here, gonna have to claim the cloud a little bit and help you guys understand that NFTs, especially as more regulatory uncertainty enters the market, where do you think all this DeFi money is gonna go if DeFi becomes more and more scrutinized by the SEC, by regulatory bodies? What do you think is gonna happen? This is all going to move into NFTs, which are going to be so hard for regulators to classify as securities. It's literally just a duck, right? It's a collectible. So there's an ultra bull narrative here for NFTs, where other parts of crypto may experience regulatory crackdowns and NFTs will have a hyper bull market. And here we are looking at the Cool Cats price chart. Again, I brought you Cool Cats super early, super duper early, where it was way less than 1 Ethereum to get a Cool Cat. Now the average price of a Cool Cat is 7.5 Ethereum. Let's hop in and see what their floor price is here. As you can see, the floor price of a Cool Cat, the cheapest Cool Cat in the world, is 7.2 Ethereum. So if you guys think that this is some kind of joke, some kind of game here, there is literally 70Xs, 100Xs, 45Xs happening every day here in crypto land. And now Cool Cats are having their own kind of Pokemon style evolvable pets that are coming from their milk token. So now I'm getting passive yield on my Cool Cats as well as my Cool Cats are mooning. So if you guys can't see what's happening here, I've been trying to give you the keys to decode the most, I guess, important change to crypto and understanding when you identify a valuable trend in crypto early. If you're too slow, you're gonna miss the Cool Cats, you're gonna miss the Subducks, you're gonna stay there looking at Bored Apes, wishing you had one, but you're gonna miss the next best things. Same with Cyber Kongs, it's been a 6X on the floor price, and this is just way less items here. But again, I'm earning my bananas here. I'm earning like something like some crazy amount of passive yield on my Cyber Kong Genesis. So just understand this has been an absolutely amazing play as well. And finally, this is one I just got told about this morning from the Cyber Kongs Discord. And so I jumped right in. It's this project Monster Buds. It's essentially breeding with a weed inspired NFT. So you can breed these strains of weed to create new ones. It's a little confusing. It's a super confusing launch. But what I'd say, what I've been doing is I've just been going in and selecting item type and making sure I'm choosing monster here. And then once you know you have chosen Monster here, again, the collection's not even verified, so make sure it's Monster Buds, one word, no symbols at the end, and the current trading volume's about 257 with a floor price of 0.1, 921 owners and 8.4K items. Make sure all of this kind of matches up because there's a bunch of scammy ones here on OpenSea. And so all of these here, as you can see, the floor price here is as cheap as 0.1. Based on how bullish some of these Kongs are, I just took a flyer. I have no idea if this is going to be a huge project or not. I bought, I think, about four or five of these so far. But the artist behind this one is behind another project called Non-Fungible Bones, which was super, super beloved and popular across NFT Twitter over the last week or so. And so the artist is well-reputed, as well as they have the breeding mechanics. It's kind of like a CryptoKitties Axie Infinity for weed with a good artist. So people are really liking this concept. So there you have it, gems that I'm looking to scoop up on the dip if there is a capitulation candle here in crypto land. I don't believe in any way that this FUD is going to restrict a Q4 giga bull run. So I'm here preparing for it and going super long on the projects that I think are not only high quality, but important to the newest and least saturated ecosystems in crypto land, whether that's Avalanche, Solana, Polkadot, or NFTs. I've been trying to give you the keys to the kingdom, and I'm going to continue to do so. And if that's a value to you, make sure you smash that like button and subscribe, of course, because these videos are ultra time sensitive. Imagine if you had seen the video for SupDucks when it was 0.1, you'd be up 45x right now. And that's not going to stop. We're going to keep giving you the keys to the kingdom here. So make sure you subscribe, put that bell notification on, and I'll keep you up to date with the best information in the space. With that said, my name is EllioTrades. You can find me on Twitter at EllioTrades, and I'll see you very soon on the next episode.